Hello, this is Seth Wendy. Welcome to another in-car movie review, and tonight I went to see Black Panther. Now, I had seen Casey Neistat's review of the Black Panther a couple days ago, and I thought it was a spectacular review. The review holds water. And what I just saw was probably one of the best, if not the best, superhero movie I've seen in years. It's so fresh. It's written and directed by Ryan Coogler, and he's just an amazing person. This is his third film, and it really is on a different level than other directors. It really relies on backstory of everyone, but it's in context. It's just telling a story that I haven't heard before. I didn't know when I was a kid, J.J. and Punisher, what I knew, and I didn't stray too far into the actual superhero realm. So, this movie is completely fresh. It tells a story. It has to get through the actual backstory of who Black Panther is, and what Black Panther does, and what he's fighting for. It has an amazing cast, including Lupita Nyong'o, Angela Bassett, Forest Whitaker, and it's deep with the need to tell a story about African existence. Now, when I got out of the movie theater, I heard that most of the moviegoers compared it to the Lion King because the Black Panther, when he visits his ancestors, and this is a common story element in Africa. It's also a common story in Asia. I'm half Asian, and I get that in a lot of old Asian stories where Asian characters consult their forefathers and foremothers. There also was a sunset in the end, and because people are really, really white where I am, and they don't know other cultures, they immediately associate it with the Lion King. But because they were always referencing that Wakanda had the most beautiful sunsets in the world. Half of my family is from Hawaii. That's the Asian half. And I will tell you that the sunset in Hawaii is one of the most beautiful sunsets you will ever see. It's amazing. And the pictures, some of the pictures, the sky is on fire. So I know that the sunset of someone's home is just the most beautiful in the world. And sometimes I just don't like all the references to the Lion King because it cheapens the story and what they were doing with flipping the narrative. Africa is a poor continent and everyone's in poverty. That isn't true. I have slightly more education on Africa than the average white Asian person. That's because I volunteer as a peer advisor, Young African Leadership Initiative at Dartmouth. And I have many African friends, and they have vibrant cultures, and they have amazing stories about their homelands. In Nigeria, for instance, is like the Bollywood or the Hollywood of Africa. It's just so rich with art and film and music. Ghana has music too. And we, as white Americans, or half Asian Americans, don't know anything about it because all we hear about is news of famine and unrest. So I hope this film changes some people's minds about the most misunderstood continent in the world. And I'm gonna drop off my soapbox. I think you should see this movie. It's going to go huge. I look forward to this film a lot more than Infinity War because it's just the third installment of the Avengers, and it just doesn't say anything really new. I'm still gonna see it. I'm still gonna like it. But it was nothing like Black Panther. I hope you have a good weekend. I hope you see Black Panther. And I hope you enjoy yourself. Have a good day.